But in DLR, even if you solve 1,000 sets, there always are 1 lakh more sets that are waiting for you. So that you will find on the day of exam only.
Okay, so hi everyone. Welcome on board to Cat King. This is Anisha here in conversation with Pratham, who is a fresher GEM category student who made it to SPGEN Mumbai with CAT 97 percentile. And the best part is, he has a DILR 98 point. What's the exact percentile, Pratham? 98.6,
I guess. I'm not too
sure. Okay. Yeah. That's lovely. So, you know, DILR has always been the struggle area. Yeah. Everybody's like, kitne attempt karne, kya karna hai? How do you prepare? You know, it's so different. It's not conventional DILR. Right. So what was your preparation strategy for it? And what helped you make sure you get a 99.6 percentile in that?
As you mentioned, DILR is something which is not what you can directly prepare, like a quant, where you are very clear about what to prepare. You have those concepts, you have questions to practice. In verbal also, to some extent, you have those different RCs which you can practice daily. But in DILR, even if you solve 1,000 sets, there always are 1 lakh more sets that are waiting for you. So that you will find on the day of exam only. So what my strategy was in DILR was that I will do a limited number of sets. I won't try to, you know, pull myself on doing 20 sets a day. I will just practice maybe a 3 or 4 sets in a day, good sets in a day. And if I am able to do it, I feel that I will try to figure out if there was a shorter method to do it, if I could do it in a lesser amount of time. And if I wasn't able to somehow make it, then I would try to figure out that where did my thought process go wrong. So having a good thought process when doing DILR is the most important thing, because you can never have a fixed, you know, method which goes on from the starting till the end that you have in a quant question. So you start from something, you have some steps, and then you go till the end. In DILR, that is never the case. It is always more important to have a good thought process while solving DILR. You have that limited number of limited time. We had around 40 minutes in CAT, and you know, we had to manage to do 2 or 3 sets. I did almost 2.5 sets to manage around 98-99 percentile in DILR. So what my thing was that I had to read all the sets. Basically, I read all the sets slowly. I figured out that what was the best set for me to attempt in that limited period. Because if you get stuck at a single set, then you are gone. You have to select the best set in the starting, and you have to go stepwise. You have to keep, you know, you have to maintain your calm, because 10 minutes you are just investing in the set. You are reading it throughout and you are just figuring out whether you are able to do or not. So that 10 minutes, you have to do it very well. Once you do the set, once you are done with the set in 10 to 12 minutes, then the 4 or 5 questions that follow are like a 30 seconds task for you. Mm-hmm. So that is the thing, to go in order, to have the right thought process, to follow all the steps, to not miss anything. And yes, practice as much as you can. Try a different number of sets, different types of sets that makes your thought process, you know, builds your thought process, expands your, you know, brain at, in different directions. And that is what can help you. It's not a single fixed strategy that can be followed, but it's just exploring all the different sets that are available. So that is what worked for
me. That's lovely. So, you know, you keep learning, you keep exploring. Yes. On the day of the exam, which slot did you have for CAT?
I had slot 3, ma'am, the last slot, evening slot.
So, you know, by then, slot 1, slot 2, everyone's talking so much. DILR is, yes, ma'am. DILR is that, or the whole exam from that perspective. Right. So what do you suggest on that day if you're getting slot 3? What should you be doing? Yes. And how did you make sure that whatever was feedback of 1 and 2 doesn't affect you?
Okay, so ma'am, what I personally think is that, you know, going by what these people say of slot 1 and slot 2, you shouldn't, you know, worry about which section is going to was tough in slot 1 and slot 2. Like some people said that quant was really tough in slot 1, DILR was really tough in slot 2. So all these things, what they do is, you know, they make you feel a certain bias that in the slot 3 as well, it will be tough, but it is never the case. In every slot, you find that different sections are, you know, at different levels. So that is never the case. That shouldn't be taken into consideration in the day of exam. What should be taken into consideration is that what is the paper pattern, because it will remain same throughout the day. Yeah. So if the slot one guys comes and says that, you know, we had 24 questions in verbal, 22 in DILR and 20 in quant. So that will remain same throughout the day. So that is what can help you form your strategy for the exam. And that is really important, I feel, to know as well. Because if I know that there are only 20 questions in quant, then I do not need to hurry in a way that I was doing in mocks. Because in mocks, we had around 24 questions. to do in a single go. So like the previous year. So if I know that there are only 20 questions, then I can give a bit more time to each question to solve. And then I can, you know, reorganize my strategy in a way that is good for me. So that can, that things can be taken into consideration, the paper pattern and these stuff, but which section was tougher or which section was slightly easier. So that those things do not work in different slots. So that shouldn't be taken. And those questions also should not be, you know, discussed or seen, because the questions aren't anyway going to be same. So yeah.
That. Absolutely. That, and it differs from person to person. What's good for him or easy for him might be tough for me. So that's really important advice. So thank you so much, Pratham, for sharing your DILR strategy with us. And for people who are super scared of DILR, the only secret to it is practicing all types of questions right from the start. So stay tuned. And thank you so much, Pratham, for joining on board with us today.
Thank you so much, man. Thank you.